Hi guys! In this video, I will show you how I made this simple yet powerful inverter that can easily light a 220 volt LED bulb. This inverter can be powered by a USB power bank or even a 9 volt battery. So, let's build this thing! First things first, get yourself an old computer power supply. Carefully remove the cover and unscrew the main circuit board from the case. But please be careful with the huge capacitors over here. This thing can kill you. Make sure to short the capacitor pins before removing anything from the board. So we are interested with these switching transformers. I simply desoldered the transformer from the circuit board using a desoldering pump. After that, it will come off easily. Let us now find the primary, the secondary, and the feedback winding of the transformer. Set your multimeter to the continuity function or to the lowest ohmic value. Pins having the highest resistance among the other pins will be our secondary winding. In my case, it's 2.9 ohms. For the primary, I simply chose these pins because it has the thickest wire among the others. And the feedback windings will be these pins adjacent to the secondary winding. So, here's the schematic diagram of our circuit. We will need an N-channel MOSFET, so I chose an IRF-Z44N, a 1 kilo ohm resistor, and a reasonably big heatsink. So let's begin soldering. For the output of our inverter, solder extension wires to the secondary winding of the transformer. Then insulate it using heat shrink tubing. Next, solder a 1 kilo ohm resistor to either pins of our feedback windings. For the positive input of our inverter, take an 18 gauge stranded copper wire and strip at least an inch of its insulation. By the way, I got this wire from the same power supply that we dismantled earlier. Using the stripped wire, bridge the other pin of the feedback winding to either pins of the primary winding. So I chose this pin over here. It should look like this. Before soldering the transistor, be sure to identify each pin. MOSFETs have three pins: the gate, drain, and source. Be sure to check your transistor's datasheet in order to identify its pins. Now solder the drain of the MOSFET to the other pin of the primary winding. And the gate to the 1 kilo ohm resistor. Finally, add an extension wire to the source pin of your MOSFET. This will be our negative input. Make sure to also add insulations as well. To make the inverter compact, I made another hole near the edge of the heatsink. Secure the transistor to the heatsink using a fine threaded screw or any screw that will work with you. If you're using a non-anodized heatsink, it is a good idea to add insulating tape on the part where the transformer sits. And now, our circuit is done! To test the inverter, get yourself a light receptacle and a 220 volt LED bulb. You can also use a compact fluorescent light bulb. Connect the output of the inverter to the light receptacle. To power everything, you can use a USB power bank. However, I use this adjustable DC to DC step-down converter in order for me to adjust the voltage. I then lowered the output voltage of the step-down converter to 5 volts. Simply connect the input of the inverter to the step-down converter. Turn on the converter and voila! The LED lit up and did not explode it. Great! I also tried powering the inverter using a 9 volt battery, and it works like a charm. The minimum input voltage of this inverter is 2 volts. And please, do not use this inverter to power anything aside from LED and compact fluorescent lights. Otherwise, the authorities might see you crying outside your burning house. So that's it guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video and please subscribe to my channel. See you later.